So we just had the old bug eye common there at 11 pound, which was a nice capture because he's been in the swim almost since day one feeding on the bait. And what we're going to do now, because there's loads of fish out there and they're feeding heavily now, we're going to go back to what we wanted to test originally and see if pop-ups are as ineffective in the clear water during the day as we were led to believe in part one. So this is the rig I'm going to put out, slightly changed from the beginning of the video. Basically what I've done, I've put the shot right underneath the hook there, so it's just going to sit like that on the bottom, just the length of the hook off the bottom. Tiny little fusion pop-up, handmade fusion pop-up, made exactly the same way as I made the NRG pop-ups in part two. And a 20 pound hybrid hook link, which is slightly stiff. You can see there's some stiffness to it. But the thing I've done since we've been doing the filming here is I've added some of the Gardner critical mass tungsten putty to the middle of that hook link, just to hold it down on the bottom. It sinks perfectly anyway. The braid inside this hybrid actually takes water on, which is unusual for these types of braids because most of them float. So you've got fluorocarbon around that sinking braid, but I've added that extra just to keep it all down on the deck, because that's one of the things we've noticed. Anything off the deck, they don't like it at all. So we're going to put that out. I reckon it's going to get treated with suspicion, but they're feeding heavily, and if we catch one on it, I'm going to put a braided pop-up rig on and see how that fares. But what I'm going to do first of all is just hook on a little bit of the solar foam, because I'm not going to put a bag on this one, because I don't want the fish feeding on the contents of the bag on the bottom. There you go, like that. Don't want the fish feeding on the contents of the bag right on the bottom and ignoring that or spooking off of that. So I'm not going to put anything around it, which is again unusual. A lot of people, myself included, have fished bags with pop-ups a lot in the past. Personally, when you think about it, the bag's melted, they're eating the bag. Why have something above it? And you know, I've done it myself, and from looking at the footage here, you know, I really don't think it's the one. If they're feeding on the bottom, you want a bottom bait on, definitely. So we're going to get that back out in the swim now. We've been told that there's fish already in there feeding, which is another thing that happens a lot. As soon as you catch one, the fish are in there behind it because they know they're not going to get caught, because one's just got dragged out of the swim. So they're not stupid by any stretch. So we're going to just check with our man in the bivvy and make sure the coast is clear, and then we're going to get out there. Going this one. Whew. Tell you what, he keeps taking line. Our line marker's taking a bit of a battering. This is on a 20 pound. Oh, he's going, he's going, he's going. Fortunately, out there we've got quite a bit of deep water. But you just never know what's in the margins. There was a tree just in the margins to our right. Give you an idea, that line marker's still 12 foot. Oh God, that's bumping over something there. Oh, God, mate, this is going, this fish. It's just bumped over a couple of branches or something off the bottom. In the bank, these fish obviously know something I don't. God, he's right in, right under the bank. Right, John, have you netted a carp before? You have to wait until they're over the cord and then you lift.
Yeah, but I get excited.
I know. I've seen you excited, John.
Have I ever lost one for you yet, Sam?
No, that's very true. Come on, mate, he's going. There's got to be boils coming up from that. God, mate.
Scrap, isn't it?
What a proper scrap these fish give. This is a little sort of 12 mil-ish. Oh. God. God, mate. It's... I haven't even seen him yet. Proper old bite though, that was for sure. Oh.
It's got to be one of the better ones.
It's got to be. I tell you what, I'm tempting fate now, right? But what a lot of people do wrong at this point is they slacken off and the hook falls out. So I'm going to, oh, mind the pole cam. I'm just going to keep the pressure on him and just wear him down. It's a mirror. Not as big as we thought, actually.
Very welcome.
Very, very welcome. Well, that's on my little hybrid pop-up rig, so what we're going to do now, whatever happens here, we're going to put on a braided pop-up rig and see what the reaction to that is. Contrary to a lot of popular opinion, we've got a steaming run on the running rig rather than the funny tape. And they don't seem to be spotting the tubing and stuff as much as they were, which is nice. We've moved a little bit. Oh, he's a lovely fish. Hooked in the top lip. Go on, John. Yeah! Come on! And he's hooked in the top lip. Oh, no, he's hooked in the side of the mouth and it's gone into the top lip where he was tearing off so much. Let's just get that out of the way. Roll him over. Three scales there.
Go for 18.
Okay, John. Now you're a bit under there, John. Yeah. 17 pounds.
Okay, thanks.
Right. Just dip him. Oh, take it. £17 of muscle. Beautiful little fish. Don't want to let him go really. They're that hard to catch in this clear water. But stunning. Stunning little carp. Again, another miniature 30 pounder. Okay, let's get him back. Pucker! Excellent, right. As I said, we've just had a fish on the hybrid, short hybrid hook link, caught in the side there. Unfortunately, tore a little bit, caught back in the top. The fish was really, really going, so I had to give it some, unfortunately. But we're going to put out a little tiny braided pop-up rig now. We're fishing a bit further away from the camera, which is making a difference. The closer we are to the camera, the more spooky they are, because obviously you've got all the contraption of the camera there. So we've moved about 3 feet away. We can just about pick out the pop-up in the gloom. And it's worked. We noticed there were a few fish come up to it and turned away from it, spooked off it, but one didn't, and that was the one we got. So, you know, we'll put a braided one out and see if they start spooking away from that, or if they pick it up and get rid of it, or if they hook themselves. So let's get that one tied and get it out there.